Hey everyone, I know it's been a while since I've actually done a video. I do apologize, but I'll probably be getting back into doing videos because this topic right here had me heated yesterday and it just got me wanting to do more videos. Anyways, I do have a disclaimer coming up, but to drive the point home, please do not send hate to anyone including BoxyCharm. I just found this information to be deceiving on BoxyCharm's end and feel that us as consumers who purchased this box deserve to know. In my opinion, BoxyCharm has gone from caring about their customers to strictly business and marketing. And why do I think that? Well, I've been getting BoxyCharm for about 3 or 4 years now, and when I first started getting it, there was a wait list, only a couple variations, and customer service? They got back to you in a reasonable amount of time. Now you'll be lucky if you get an answer in a week. And when they finally do answer your email, it's usually a copy and paste kind of answer, and it doesn't answer your question at all. Also, have you noticed they promote the good variations at the beginning of the month, and then when you got your box, you wonder where the eyeliners and lip liners come from? I think they're trying to trick us into staying with BoxyCharm because we all used to at least get the big ticketed item, so we would just pass off and write off the fact that we got the liners and such because we thought we were getting a good deal. Now I think they're getting a high volume of emails because customers are catching on and getting pissed off. But yeah, that's just a little bit of my rant. I could go on and on and on, but I'm just gonna go ahead and jump into the facts. Lego. Okay, so I pretty much got this variation right here, except I got the other Pro Glow palette, and my variation was number 35, and I was a little pissed about it, and I'll show you why. And as you can tell by the picture on the right, I already had the Pro Glow palette with the setting powder that I got from BoxyCharm just a few months ago, and then this month they want to send me the Pro Glow palette with blush and an under eye setting powder. To me, these are just too similar and too close together. A lot of people thought that we were all getting a Dose of Colors palette. A Tarte palette was not mentioned until October 1st, and the Dose of Colors palette was mentioned in the middle of September as a spoiler. I found a few different websites and of at least 5 YouTube channels that mentioned that everyone will be getting a DOC palette. People just aren't pulling this out of thin air. So when I went onto Twitter and Instagram, I seen a lot of people voicing their opinions about it. I pulled a few of the comments to show you on here. I did, however, block the screen name out for their privacy. And this is what people had to say. BoxyCharm, again, misleading people with false advertisement. My mom resubbed and you guys tricked her with this email. Proof in the email clearly said that she'll be getting a Dose of Colors palette with her box and a free gift, and she's actually receiving the Glam Glow cleanser. Same here, the cleanser's not equal to the palette. Disappointed because I got a Tarte palette just like this from you guys back in June and a setting powder last time. I've been a customer since 2016 and I think I need to stop. The last few boxes have been disappointing. That's my exact box, but I'm confused. I thought everyone was supposed to get a Dose of Color eyeshadow palette. Can anyone confirm? Why are we getting products you're trying to get rid of? We want new stuff, not junk in the back of the storage room. Why does it say some of our charmers? I thought every charmer was getting a Dose of Colors palette. That seems very strange. You guys announced it multiple times and in your box preview that everyone would be getting the palette. It is starting to feel dishonest. You made it seem like the Dose of Colors palette was the main item that everyone would be getting. And that was just a few of the many, many comments on Instagram and Twitter. Hold up one quick second. As I was editing this video, BoxyCharm ended up posting a video on their YouTube channel showing all of October's box. They were saying you could have got this or you could have got that, but when it came to the Dose of Colors, it didn't say or a Tarte palette, it was just Dose of Colors palette. I will show you a little brief clip of that video. Now, that clip shows you that you could either get the iconic spray or the glass bomb. And at the beginning, there was no sign of a Tarte palette being a variation. All you seen was the Dose of Colors. I also ran across these two promotions, which kind of infuriated me, and I'll let you know why. If you are new to BoxyCharm and you sign up this month, not only will you get the Dose of Colors palette, but you'll also get a Tarte palette, which is fine. If you sign up, you deserve an extra product because it's a great promotion. I get it. Now, on the other hand, if you try to cancel your BoxyCharm, they're gonna tell you you don't wanna miss out, which is on the Dose of Colors palette. So what are you gonna do? Scroll down and hit no, take me back. Now, why does this piss me off just a little bit? For one, I've been with BoxyCharm for 3 to 4 years. Two, this right here, once been within the last few months, 3. New members not only get the extra product, which is fine, they deserve it, they signed up, but they are guaranteed to also get the featured product of the month. And the last one, number 4, people wanting to cancel BoxyCharm, all they have to do is scroll down and hit No Take Me Back, and they get the Dose of Colors palette. It all boils down to, what about us loyal customers who have been here for years, the ones who pay every single month but no questions asked without the thought of canceling? I mean, what are we, chocolate liver? Do we not deserve the most hyped up and featured product for that month? I mean, if you have extra stock from the prior boxes, why not give those to the new charmers and not us? And this is why I think BoxyCharm has turned from caring about their customers to being all about business and marketing. They're more for the sell, 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 while they leave their dedicated customers in the dust. Okay, so the last part is more about how BoxyCharm as a brand has changed and how they keep on biting off more than they can chew. Like bigger value and bigger boxes. Anyways, moving on to the next segment, and oh, it's a big one, how BoxyCharm has not been so forthcoming nor telling the truth to their charmers. Now, prior to the changes coming up next month, BoxyCharm has always thrived on you only paying $21 a month for 5 full-size products with the retail value of over $100. Again, I say retail value of over $100. As you see here, these are a few variations from this month, October 2019. If you look where the arrows are, all 3 of these have one thing in common, and that's the go-to beauty face mask. And these look very familiar to me. I cannot find a screenshot of anybody sharing the prices, like the card that they come on, but I went on to Andrea's video, and she always says the prices of each product that she reads from the card. And BoxyCharm claims that these masks are $19.98 for both, which means they're claiming they're about $10 each. I'm going to show you how that's a lie and how something feels really shady about it all. Well, do you know about a girl that goes by the name Bad Baby? Her real name is Danielle Bergoli, and she appeared on Dr. Phil for being an obnoxious teen. She is known for saying this.
Catch me outside, how about that?
Now here's an article that I found on TMZ. They said that the source told TMZ that Danielle just signed a 6-month deal with Copycat Beauty that'll pay her $900K to promote their beauty and makeup products. Now, I know Copycat Beauty because as a YouTuber, I wanted to check this line out, but when the reviews started coming in, the quality seemed off. People's eyes were burning, there was hardly any pigment, and not the fact that they're copying off of so many brands that worked really hard. But anyways, this will all make sense in a minute. Let's go ahead and go to the Copycat Beauty website. Now, as you can see at the top, I am on copycatbeauty.com. Now, as their name obviously states, they are copying off of bigger brands. And as you can see here, there's a Copycat Beauty Cherry Bomb Eyeshadow Palette for $12 that's supposed to knock off the Urban Decay Naked Cherry Eyeshadow Palette. And as we scroll down, they're trying to knock off a lot of brands, very cheap. And here, they're trying to copy off the Stila Glitters. And it says it right on the packaging, but also on the packaging, it says Go To Beauty. And they also say Go To Beauty on the lip glosses that they had that they're trying to copy off of ABH for only $4. And then they're trying to copy off of MAC for only $3. Now, when everybody found out about Copycat Beauty, they wondered why Go To Beauty was on the packaging, but nobody knew why. They thought maybe just rebranding. Now, keep in mind, when we go to the second part, that eyeshadow palettes were only $12. Alright, now I'm going to the search bar and going to face mask, and when that comes up, you can see some of the ones that people got in BoxyCharm are in there, and they're going for $10, but they all seem sold out, which is kind of odd to me. And if we do the math, BoxyCharm was wrong by 2 cents, because they're not $19.98, they would be $20, but that's just a little, you know, just a little white lie, but you're going to see a big difference here in a minute. Alright, I want you to keep this in mind before we go to the next video, that the eyeshadow palettes were only $12, lipsticks were only $3, and then going on to the face masks that are pricey for $10, which makes no sense when you get a Dr. Jart face mask for only $12. Alright, now here's the next video from Danielle Bergoli that I found on YouTube.
Works the product better than your fingers.
So these Shima are $1 each.
Yeah,
I would definitely use these. I love face masks. I love skincare type shit. There is aloe, red pomegranate, lavender. This one I think is Sakura, green tea. And these stay on for 10 minutes, so they're not that long. But yeah, they're cool, whatever. And then here is charcoal, tomato, and egg white. And then there is 24 karat gold. I know all you Instagram hoes like to do this one and take pictures, so make sure you buy this one. It's only $1. And we're gonna open this.
Yep, you heard it right. She said that they were $1. So BoxyCharm is claiming that they're $10. And on the Copycat Beauty website, they're saying that they're $10 as well, but they're all sold out. If you break down this BoxyCharm, the Iconic London is $25 on Ulta website. Hank and Henry mascara was $19. Smashbox is $22. And then the Dose of Colors is $32. So when you add up the box before the face mask, it is only $98. Then add the face mask in, it's only $100, and which does not live up to what BoxyCharm claims to be over a value of $100. I don't know if Copycat is working with BoxyCharm or what the deal is, because it's kind of odd how the eyeshadow palette is almost as much as a face mask and the face masks are all sold out. It's just odd. Here lately, BoxyCharm value has been really low, so it seems they inflate prices to make it legit, which I have a problem with. If BoxyCharm did not know about this, then they are at fault for not doing their research on this brand. Have you seen a channel name on YouTube named Not So Evil Stepmother? She has been catching on to BoxyCharm as well. I will leave her channel link below so you can check her out. So what's crazy to me is they're having a hard time making that $100 value mark as it is, so what they're having us do is pay more each month while they up the value, while adding add-ons. It's crazy. I don't see why they just couldn't have said, hey, we're gonna have to raise the box up to $25 so we can try to get you better products, not promising more value when they can't even keep up the value now. So yeah, that's all I had to say today. I feel like it's shady business, and I feel like while we're paying customers, we deserve to know. And not only that, BoxyCharm has been a real big miss for me here lately. I'm gonna give it till the end of December to see if I'm gonna keep that subscription or not. Ipsy Glam Bag Plus has been a real big hit for me here lately, except for this past month and the Ultimate was a disaster. But that's gonna be my next video and showing you that if you was not happy with it, there is a way to correct it. I'm also gonna get back to my TJ Maxx video, so keep an eye out for that. And I'm also gonna get back to doing my unboxings on the channel as well. If you know of any new subscription boxes that are knocking it out of the park, let me know and I will see if I can get them. So yeah, before you leave, if you want to, you can hit the subscribe button along with the little notification bell so you can get notified every time I upload a video. And if you could do me a big favor and hit that like button, I would greatly appreciate it. You can also follow me on all my social media, that's SimplyBonnieMUE on Instagram and Twitter. Until my next video, I will talk to you later. Bye!